Hello, my name is Lewis Herms, founder of Screw Big Gov. We genuinely appreciate your support to Screw Big Gov in our efforts to keep all this fantastic content absolutely free to the public. Therefore, we'd love you to check out our high-quality Screw Big Gov swag, such as t-shirts, hats, and much, much more, or our cutting-edge healing and nutritional products that help you be the best you can be, including super flavorful mycotoxin and mold-free coffee. We even offer a secure place to purchase gold and silver, or you can donate directly to Screw Big Gov. You must know that I have personally vetted each and every product and service to make sure we only supply to you, our SBG family, the very, very best. All vendors on our platform are informed that if they do not live up to the SBG standards, they will be removed indefinitely. Just visit screwbiggov.com/shop. Screwbiggov.com. And it's very interesting. And you say often, I'd like to touch on this, that the reality is there's a bigger boss to these people in their minds. And I'd like you to detail that because I find it very interesting because my personal belief is I don't think they look at us as human. We're subhuman or we're cattle. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, of course, I talk about it in the book and Kid by the Side of the Road. The real short answer, and most people have heard me say this already, so I don't want to over-repeat it or if they've read it, etc. But this crowd that we're fighting all over the world, this club, if you will, ultimately they're the 13 bloodline families. So, for example, the mace, this banded together stick that is in these emblems around our country and around the world, this Roman mace. It's 13 sticks that are bound together. And even the windings that bind it can arguably be said to be like the DNA, this shape and counter-rotating DNA strands that bind it together. Well, the 13 bloodline families, bloodline from what? Their bloodline from, they believe that Eve, when she was seduced in the garden, the word that's used in the English language is beguiled. Beguiled means has very specific sexual innuendo. And so their belief is that Eve was beguiled in the garden and that the original sin was that Eve had sex with the serpent, the devil, the green man, all this green revolution, all this greening of the planet. Satan, Lucifer, the devil was one of his names. He goes by a thousand names. He, she, it goes by a thousand names. Is bisexual, is asexual, is, you know, both sexes at the same time. And goes by one of the names is the Green Man. Why? Because he hid amongst the leaves, the green leaves in the garden, specifically the fig leaves, and then beguiled Eve. And she bought into the lie. And then she went and found Adam and taught him the trick. And so their belief is that Cain and Abel were born as twins, two different fathers by the same mother in the same birth cycle. And this is actually, you know, medically, it happens more commonly than people realize. I was just talking with a physician who delivered a black child and a white child from the same mother, two different fathers,
Wow.
as twins. And, in their clinic here, you know, year or so ago. So, again, it's not that uncommon. And the mother was, you know, doing a sex trade type of thing. So at the end of the day, they believe that they're more than human, that Lucifer, this alien to the garden, not just mere human, Eve was taken out of Adam's side and created a female to go with the male, but taken out of his side. So she was of the same flesh as Adam. But this child was from this Satan, serpent, Lucifer, Samael, goes by all these different names, was a different father. Christ said, you do that which is of your father, the devil. You know, there's this ongoing theme of who's the true father of these people, who are they worshiping? And then even now into the present, you know, just to build it up further, just for those that may have not heard this before, when we see these names down through the Bible where it gives every single so-and-so begot, so-and-so begot, so-and-so begot, so-and-so. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, why is that so critical back to Adam? You don't see Cain listed in the scriptures as a descendant of Adam. And one of the key things that people have to keep in mind, it's not, you know, well, that's not in the Bible. I don't believe that. It doesn't matter what you believe. It's what they believe. And as I've said in numerous publications that I've done over the years, belief is the driver of action. So what you believe determines how you act, how you think, what you do with your time, the way you apply yourself, your belief. If you worship money, you act accordingly. If you worship sex, you act accordingly. If you worship, you know, one God or the other, or a different God, it determines how you function in daily life in a moral or immoral way. You know, Crowley, who many of these people regard as one of their great prophets and sentinels in the occult religions, Crowley bragged on wanting to be able to sacrifice young boys. Mm-hmm. And it was claimed that he sacrificed 150 boys at least, at a minimum, a year. Wow. So these types of practices to worship their God, you say, well, that's just one guy. Well, in the Bible, what's it talk about? Those who were worshiping Baal and Moloch, who went up on the hills around the Holy Land, and then they worshiped their god Baal and Moloch. How? By making their children to pass through the fire. That's very Sunday school church way of saying they roasted their children alive in the arms of a idol, a god, Baal, as a sacrifice just to get, you know, a good harvest, to get protection, to get all sorts of things. I don't care what it is they were hoping to get. It was insane. It was evil to its core. And the god that would require that is still around today. That's the god that Crowley was worshiping 100 years ago, 150 years ago.
Yeah.
You think it's gone now? As a closing thing in that particular realm, let me just add this. When Hillary wanted to do this speech in the 2016 election period, she wanted to do this, you know, final few days before the election, she wanted to speak in this copy, this styrofoam copy of the Arch of Baal. The Arch of Baal was blown up by Al-Qaeda over in Syria. And, but just before it was blown up, it was a very detailed photographic rendition was made of it. A very precise photographic rendition was made, 3D. And then this World Historical, you know, Society made a copy of it in styrofoam, this huge archway. And the reason that that's relevant is because archways are considered to be a gateway between the eternal realm and the physical realm, between the spirit realm and the physical realm. So you see it in videos, music videos, commercials, all sorts of theater, where the mirror or archways are this stepping through point to the other side. Mm-hmm. And so Hillary wanted to speak in that archway of Baal. Well, wait a second, where did it come from? The archway of Baal was at the base of Mount Hermon. Mount Hermon is the location that has the highest heritage site, UN heritage site in the world. And the UN heritage site is like at 6,000 some odd feet up there. And it's this little temple area at the top of Mount Hermon. Mount Hermon is the place where in the Sumerian history and the Babylonian history, the 200 aliens, if you will, 200 gods fell to earth. And that's where they landed. And then they came down to the people of the earth, and they built a temple called the Temple of Baal, B-A-A-L. And at the Temple of Baal, they would meet the human occupants of the earth. And they had this city of Baal. There was a gateway, and that's the Arch of Baal. The city of Baal, that wall was all torn down and destroyed by some prior generations who were smart enough to understand that these weren't their friends. But the archway still persisted. But that's where the people would come and bring their children and offer them to these gods, if you will, at the city of Baal, who was the head of all those 200 that fell. And they would sacrifice their children there. Now, remember, myths, legends, all these sorts of things, oftentimes they have some basis in reality. We've got the temple site at the top of Mount Hermon. The UN's recognized it. We have the archway. It was a physical reality. Exactly what the truth is about, you know, gods or Olympians or all sorts of things, it's been morphed to tell a tale. It's kind of Hollywood. We create a myth of reality versus what the true reality is. So they've created this myth that they're somehow gods over man, etc. Within all these blended ideas, blended religious concepts, we're trying to sort through what the real history is, as opposed to what somebody else is tweaking the history to sound like to fit their scenario. You know, the victors write the history. Right. And so whatever way they've done it, these monsters have created a history that has a certain illusion to it, a certain belief system to it. And part of it is that they're worshiping their God by sacrificing human children, and that is somehow gets them in favor with their God. Well, you know, for a God that wants to take over the planet, getting rid of the humans and having the humans do it themselves somehow makes a certain type of sense. And by the way, in all of these things, the false flags, the various scenarios that we find being played out around the world, one common theme that your listeners have to be super, super sensitive to, they believe in their gods. They believe in a God beyond their Lucifer God. And they believe that they avoid judgment by getting you to do the dirty deed. Mm. So if you sacrifice your child, the bad karma, if you will, is on you, not them. Yeah. They didn't do it. They may have beguiled you, convinced you that there somehow was an advantage for doing that, but you did it out of your own free will. You made that choice. And so the devil's mechanism is still the same. In the scriptures, it talks about this great day of judgment somewhere out in the future when the great white throne judgment, and Satan, Lucifer, the devil, is brought before all the assembly of all the humans that ever lived. And the people look at this creature and they say, is this the one who deceived the whole world? This worm? Well, why? Why use the word worm? Yeah. Because it doesn't have hands and feet. Yeah. It only has the power of persuasion. Were its hands and feet. The serpent was forced to crawl on the ground, but the hands and feet, that's what we see in the dragon symbology. Why? Because when the serpent, the worm, is combined with the human, the combined DNA, now it becomes like a dragon. It now has hands and feet. We do its will. We do its various function. And so we come all the way back to the beginning of this conversation a moment ago. What's really running the planet at various levels are these 13 bloodline Cain families, the children of Cain, the Cains of the earth, kings, Cains, ruling over us, the right to rule by blood. And they believe that they are more than human because their father, Satan, Lucifer, the devil, is who conceived Cain via Eve, were merely humans. Big difference.
I'm going to kill the dragon for you, my love. I know when I'll come back, I'll find you with another lord. I'm going to break the walls for us, my love. I know when I realize, feeling free, you just have gone. You just have gone without me. You just have gone. We can't leave to someone just like you, my love.